Welcome everybody to the certificate evening for 2020. A little bit different than we normally do, obviously with lockdown and everything else, but we've put some videos together and we hope you enjoy it. Have a good night.
Hi, my favourite part of the school year is awarding these certificates for outstanding contribution to English since September. Always highly contested and always a really difficult decision. The Year 7 award goes to an incredible pupil. Not only is she kind and caring and beautiful, but she's also hardworking, determined and dedicated to being the best that she can be. So the winner of our Year 7 award goes to Lexi Machin. Moving on to Year 8, got nominated by more than one member of the department. This student has demonstrated an outstanding attitude towards her English lessons. She's endlessly hardworking, conscientious and enthusiastic. And not only this, but she's a highly valued member of Book Club, a fantastic library leader, and her contributions to the English department are invaluable. Miss White says that she's very lucky to have taught such an exceptional student, and the winner of our Year 8 award goes to Bryony Oxford. Mrs. Allen has nominated the Year 9 award. She says that this person is hardworking, committed and passionate in everything that she does. It's always been the case, but has materialised even more so during lockdown. Mrs. Allen is very proud of Lucy Clark. Moving on to Year 10, we've got the Literature Award first. This student possesses a quiet confidence which disguises her sheer brilliance. She has boundless capabilities and nothing is from her grasp. She doesn't appear to work tirelessly, she has no need to, instead she devours the task at hand, explores ideas and produces considered, measured responses. Mrs. Stevens is over the moon to award this prize to Eva McKechnie. Our Year 10 Language Award goes to somebody who is the epitome of conscientiousness. She works diligently and constantly strives to better herself. She is a model student and will certainly excel in her final year. Another one from Mrs. Stevens goes to Daisy Wheeler. And then lastly, from me, we've got the Key Stage 3 Library Award. Highly contested, really important part of the department. But Dawny says that this pupil is a delight to teach. His enthusiasm and contribution to library lessons is always outstanding. He is also a wonderful actor and his performances at St. Chad's Primary School have been a joy to watch. So she's really proud to award this award to Ashley Powell in Year 8. Thank you.
'Cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car, passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 there's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time, okay. I'm having a ball.
To present the Film Studies Awards, and we'll start with the Year 9 candidate. So I knew this student would excel in this subject from the moment I taught her, and she hasn't let me down. She works hard, produces beautiful work, and is always ready to answer questions. The standard of work that she has been submitting since the school closed has been detailed and thought through. The Year 9 award goes to Millie Powis. Okay, Year 10. This student goes about her work quietly, but this does not detract from the superb work that she produces. She understands the more complex aspects of the topic and is an example to her peers in terms of her work ethic as well as her attitude to learning. The Year 10 award goes to Kerry Lee Wade. Okay.
Don't stop me. 'cause I'm having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger defying the...
Hi, so here are the awards for the maths department for this year. So year seven, this young lady is extremely hardworking and her confidence has grown massively since she started in year seven. She's quite happy to ask questions, so she understands the work 100% of the time. Her amazing attitude has helped to achieve high in tests and also more recently in Show My Homework learning tasks. So very well done to Lula Hunt. Year 8, this young lady is extremely hardworking and she will ask questions about every topic until she has understood the topic completely. In addition to this, she's been spending over 260 minutes every week on MathsWiz to improve her skills, so very well done, Lucy Hammond. Year 9, this young man is a very hard-working young man and he puts 100% of effort into all the work he does. He's very kind and generous and is quite happy to share his work with the rest of the class and also explaining how he does things. He's always smiling and even when he makes a mistake, he'll keep trying until he gets it right. He has an amazing work ethic and he is a beautiful person to teach. So my award goes to the very deserving Samuel Pye. And year 10, this student's natural curiosity and innate problem-solving talents have helped develop a very able mathematician. His systematic approach to investigation paired with logical rationale has led to exceptional GCSE success this year. So in Mr. Powell's word, it's my boy, Brandon, my guy. So very well done, everybody.
So tell me, do you want to go?
Hello, evening everyone. So for the Science Awards, first off for year seven, is awarded to a young man who's been amazing since September. We're really impressed with his work throughout lockdown and he's had the whole of the science department talking. He's completed work to a really high standard and gone above and beyond, making his own science experiments at home. He is an absolute genius. We couldn't be more proud to award this award to Ben Parker. Well done, Ben. Second, for year eight, this person works really, really hard in lesson. He's always willing to offer great answers and he's continued to work hard whilst the school has been closed, which has been absolutely fantastic. Mr. Farr described this person as being dedicated, which is a really, really good quality to have. So keep it up and a massive, massive well done to Freddie Parry. Well done, guys.
Hello, everyone. This is Mr. Cartledge with the Year 9 and Year 10 Science Awards. The Year 9 Award goes to a young lady who fully engages with all tasks and lessons and produces exemplary work. She always asks how staff are doing when sending emails, which is lovely and much appreciated. Well done to Caitlin Jepson. The Year 10 Award goes to a young man who has worked extremely hard over the years to rise through the science sets. He's very organised with his revision notes and he's got a brilliant work ethic. So a huge well done to Sam Ruane. So massive well done from me and all the science department to all the science winners. I'll see you soon and stay safe.
The blood gonna drown a mind. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, 'cause here I come.
Everyone, it's Mrs. Edbrock here to present the awards for the celebration evening for MFL. I hope you're all well. So to start off, we've got our Year 7 award. This award goes to someone who is an absolute superstar and gives 100% in every single lesson. He's moved up a set this year and has done every single piece of work since going into lockdown. Mrs. Rutter says she's very proud of you. And that award goes to Logan Smith. Yay! Okay, next up, year eight. This is someone who is in Mrs. Orton's class. She says he is an absolute delight to teach. He really enjoys learning Spanish and has been amazing during lockdown. He's challenging himself every day to improve at home. And again, Mrs. Orton is very proud of you. And this goes to Alex Hughes. Well done, Alex. Next, we've got a girl in year nine. And this teacher is always looking forward to receiving this young lady's work because she applies both what she's learned in class and during lockdown to produce complex and high quality work every single time. She gets quietly on with the work that she's given and she is reaping the rewards. This goes to Emily Lockett. Well done, Emily. And last but not least, the award for year 10. Young lady goes to one of Mrs. Orton's classes, a young lady, and it says here she is a pleasure to teach. She participates actively in lessons and is always trying to improve every single day. Home learning has only proved that she is a very determined young lady that will do amazing at whatever she decides to do in the future. Keep up the good work, and that goes to Aisha. Well done, Aisha. Thank you, everybody. Merci, bravo. Gracias. Adiós.
Okay, so the awards for telling this year go to two pupils who have worked really hard, both in school and remotely over the last few months. They're both really ambitious. They show a huge amount of enthusiasm for Italian, and they put in their best efforts all the time. So they're absolutely brilliant people to teach. Another good thing is that they don't take life far too seriously. They're able to relax and have a laugh, even though sometimes I've no idea what they're laughing about. But they do that. They're just a fantastic pair of people to have in lessons. So my Year 9 Italian award this year goes to Liam Chamberlain. For Year 10, the award goes to Emily Borgogna. Okay, both, so congratulations. Auguri a tutte e due. Well done, and I shall hopefully see you soon. Imagine all the people.
Good evening, everyone. My favourite time of the year. We're here to celebrate the successes within the history department and the wider school for the entire academic year. When we looked as a department at who to award or who to give these awards to this year, we really struggled.
There's so much talent within the history department, so many people working so hard. It was a really difficult choice across the board. Now, as I said before, this is an unusual year and these are unusual circumstances. But there are benefits to it, specifically for me. First of all,
by this point in the evening, I've had about 15 warnings from Mr. Swindles. Keep it short, Mr. Mackin. Don't do anything silly, Mr. Mackin. And I'm getting stares from the side of the stage. You will be good, Mr. Mackin. I haven't had any of that this year. And also, there is no dress code, so I don't have to wear a suit or shirt and tie, which is absolutely fabulous and something I have taken full advantage of. On to all the winners.
No, Mr. Bond. I expect you to die. Oh, wait. No. That's the wrong video, isn't it? Excellent. I apologise. Well, no, I know what I'm here for now. I'm here to announce the Year 7 Award for CCSC. So, without further ado, congratulations to a young lady who has worked her socks off during lockdown, has achieved every single target set by Mrs. Till, and even gone beyond. And the piece of work that was mentioned to me was one about a cipher code that was used to prove that Mary, Queen of Scots, was involved in plots against Elizabeth I. So an absolutely excellent, massive congratulations and round of applause goes to Jessica Brooke. Well done.
Good day, children of Chesterton. Elizabeth I here. I have been invited by your teacher to present the History Award for the best historian in year 8. Now, I know that this historian has studied everything about Tudor life and really excelled, specifically focusing on my father and his wives, specifically my mother, of course. Now, I'm led to believe that this person played my father's fifth wife in a recent school production. So, without further ado, I would like to announce that the winner of CCSC's Year 8 History Award for 2019 to 2020 is Isabel Conyon. Well done, Isabel.
Hello, CCSC. My name is Boris and I am here from Mother Russia to announce the award for the greatest historian in all of history of Year 9. Today, this award goes to a young man who has absolutely brilliant mind, ability to recall facts, second to none, absolutely superb. There must be some Russian blood in there somewhere. I would like you to all give a big round of applause to Ryan Taylor. Well done, Ryan.
Well, hello there, everyone. I'm so stoked to see you on this Celebration Awards Assembly evening for CCSC. Is that right? CCSC? Yeah, CCSC. Now, as you can tell, I'm from America in the 50s. And in the 50s is the height of the Cold War. And the Cold War is a new topic that has been introduced to GCSE history at the start of this academic year. Now, the Year 10 Award, because they're the only ones that have studied the Cold War so far, goes to someone who has taken to this new study like a duck to water. So I'd like y'all to give a great big round of applause to Tegan Cavanna Lovett. Well done.
Shoulders, tell me what you see. Cause I am a giant. We'll be breaking borders underneath.
Okay, so the Geography Department Awards for 2020 are as follows. Year 7 goes to a young man who's applied himself extremely well consistently throughout the year. His geographical understanding is deep and he consistently wants to ask questions to improve that. His aptitude and application on activities and tasks has been second to none. That goes to Alfie Hibbert in Year 7. Second award in Year 8 goes to a young lady who Mr. Young says has worked consistently well throughout the year. She's applied herself to all activities, both in school and out of school, and has really improved in her geographical understanding. Very, very well done to Hannah Royce in Year 8. Year 9, choosing GCSEs is very, very difficult, and we always like to see people who will apply themselves to everything. This young lady has done that above and beyond. She will always ask questions. She always wants to do a little bit extra, whether that be in school or out of school. Her work is absolutely fantastic and she is very, very diligent. Her geographical understanding, both written and verbal, is very, very good, and she is a very, very good geographer. So that all goes to Iona Stanifelli. Finally, Year 10 goes to a young man in Mr. Young's class who Mr. Young has passed on a message and said that he is a fantastic geography, very, very capable, very, very good, works hard all the time, always willing to contribute in class, always willing to offer his own opinion, and shows a very, very deep understanding of geographical concepts. Has worked hard through this lockdown as well, completing tasks, completing work, and staying in touch with Mr. Young to try and further his own understanding of subjects. So the final award for Year 10 goes to Jack Salmon. Well done to all. The Geographical Department likes to thank you all and everybody else who's worked well within the school, both during school time and throughout the lockdown that we've had. Thank you.
Welcome to our PE Awards for this year, in slightly unusual circumstances. Normally I'm allowed to go on forever, but I've been restricted to a certain time frame. So without further ado, I'd like to begin with our Year 7 winner. Our Year 7 winner is a boy who has done terrifically well. Always very difficult when you start a new school to engage yourself fully in the sports programme, but this young man has been absolutely spot on. And our award for Year 7 goes to Nathan Hume. Into Year 8, we've got a fantastic young lady who's incredibly sporty. We've got great hopes for her in the future. Our Year 8 winner goes to Alina Smith. Well done, Alina. Into Year 9, terrific year group with a high number of GCSE pupils. This GCSE pupil is working incredibly hard and is very competitive across a number of sports. The winner there is Isaac Futter. Well done, Isaac. And into year 10, a fantastic young man, and I think will benefit from this award in terms of improving his confidence. He's superbly well-mannered, well-behaved, bright, hard-working, and competitive outside of school in his own sport. Our winner for year 10 is Jensen Connor. Well done to all of you. Go for the moon. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And all that glitters is gold. Everybody, hope you're having a lovely celebration evening. This is take number 7 for me, and I've got 1 minute to give out 5 awards. Stop watching now. Award number 1, year 7, we're giving to Esme Good. Congratulations, Esme. I've been massively impressed with some of the work you've sent during lockdown, particularly your internet poster. Far more exciting than I make it sound. Great job. Year 8 award is going to Jessica College. Been an absolute star during lockdown, so well done. I've received something off you every week and it's always really, really good. You deserve that award. Award number 3, year 9, computer science. This year it's going to Thea Sherlock Hammond. So if you sat at home clapping at a screen, give her a round of applause, I guess. Brilliant work off Thea. Hope you get that trip to Manchester that you're so craving. Award number 4, the coveted Year 10 award, is going this year to Lauren Tomkinson. Really, really well done, Lauren. Work that you do every week's fine. Better than fine, it's good actually. And the fact that you managed to put up with my jokes every Monday during lockdown. I appreciate that. We've got a new award as well. This award is the first time we're giving an award for iMedia. I've overran my minute. Whoops. And this award is going this year to Archie Brownsword. I've just heard nothing but good things about him from Miss Waterhouse, who just keeps telling me over and over again that he's an angel and she wants to adopt him. So a massive round of applause for all those 5 if you're at home. And a massive round of applause from me. That felt strange. I'm going to stop the video now. Spoilers, Easter eggs for this. I'm only wearing this shirt. I've got my dinosaur pajamas on, so you can have a look at them. I think that was professional. Silent Tom, Silent Tom, go and do it for me. Now watch me whip, kill it. Now watch me nay nay. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nay nay. Why me do it? Now watch me whip, kill it. Watch me nay nay. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nay. Hi and welcome to this evening's Art Awards. The first award goes to a young lady in Year 7. She produced an amazing eye drawing for a competition that we put onto Instagram, and the winner for the Year 7 Art Award is Afreen Ahmed. Yay! Next, moving on to the Year 8 Award. This person for Year 8 produced an amazing independent study right at the beginning of term last year. It's a shame she isn't taking art in year 9, but never mind, the winner is Madison Elliott. Yay! And moving on to the year 9 art award,
This person has excelled since lockdown. She's produced some amazing work. She's been my star of the week. She's also been on Miss Waterhouse's outstanding work. The winner is Lucy Clark. And moving on to the Year 10 Award, this young lady has excelled throughout Year 10. She's done an amazing job. She's independent. She works extremely hard. The winner is Elizabeth Arnold. Woo! And next, moving on to the Photography Awards, Miss Waterhouse and Miss Evans have chosen these two people. The first person for Year 9, Miss Evans and Miss Waterhouse say she works extremely hard. Even during lockdown, she's independent, she works hard. The winner is Molly Philpott. Yay! And last but not least, the Year 10 award goes to one of Miss Waterhouse's favourites. She's excelled since she's been in Year 10. I'm pleased to give this award to Nikita Mudry. Yay! That's all from me, folks.
I'm here to announce the Key Stage 3 Technology, Key Stage 4 3D Art and the Key Stage 4 Food winners. As a team, it was a very difficult decision as the awards could have gone to a number of students that have enjoyed the subject and been really enthusiastic this year. In the end, we've chosen six students that have worked extremely hard and have gone the extra mile. So, in Key Stage 3 Technology, Year 7, Zeph Machin was our winner. In Year 8, Ethan Watkiss. Key Stage 4 3D Art, in Year 9, Alan Wachowski, and in Year 10, Oliver Prince. And then for food, in Key Stage 4, Year 9, Emily Arnold, and then in Year 10, Francesca Bailey. So congratulations to all of those winners. Well done.
With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way.
Mr. Young says this person has an excellent input into every lesson, a deep understanding and knowledge of current affairs and topics, both confident and articulate in classroom discussions, but also producing both great class and lockdown work, often being showcased in the work of the week. A big round of applause to Harvey Price. Well done. And in Year 10, Mr. Young says this person is hardworking and committed to achieving high standards. Despite finding certain concepts complex, he has pushed himself to find out more about the topics he's been covering, especially if he's found them difficult, and done his best in answering exam questions. A real character who can make valuable classroom discussion contributions. He's keen to stimulate the learning of others, and a really big well done to James Hunt. Okay, that's all from me. Thanks, bye.
Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia.
Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me. For me. For me.
Good evening.
Okay, these are two awards for business studies and enterprise. And the first award is for year nine from Mr. Dean. Okay, so Mr. Dean has said that we'd like to recognise the achievement of a pupil who's worked extremely hard this year in business studies. You've demonstrated that you're motivated and eager to learn. You've also shown potential to become a great entrepreneur with the deep understanding that you're showing of the subject. He says, I know you'll continue to do very well, and I feel we'll be seeing the start of a great and successful career in business. So, the Year 9 Business and Enterprise Award goes to Lucy Brownsort. Congratulations, Lucy. Well done. Okay, and on to Year 10. This is the award from Mr. Gribbin. And Mr. Gribbin said, this student is such an asset to the class, constantly going above and beyond to ensure all the work is completed to a really high standard. As well as working hard, she's fun to have in the lesson, always has a smile on her face, and a constant willingness to help others around her if she's finished the work that's been set. Nothing is ever too much for her, and she'll always look to complete anything you ask of her, no matter how difficult or challenging that may be. Since lockdown, she's continued to work hard on all the tasks set and produce some outstanding work. The Business and Enterprise Award for Year 10 goes to Jasmine Heath. Well done, Jasmine. Congratulations both, and all the best.
I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. Even though I might not like this, I think that you'll be happier. I want you to be happier.
Hello everybody. I get the privilege of announcing our Child Development Award winners for this year. So I'm going to start with Year 9, and the nomination comes from Mrs. Felton, who says that this particular pupil has worked exceptionally hard throughout the year and also during the lockdown period. She submitted coursework tasks, recap quizzes, new learning tasks, and has had the same level of enthusiasm throughout. Her work is always to an exemplary standard, and she listens to feedback and makes sure that she improves on her work using that feedback. A real fantastic effort throughout the year. So the Year 9 award goes to Lydia Gordon. Well done, Lydia. And on to Year 10, the nomination comes from Mrs. Allen, who says that this student is hardworking, dedicated, and self-motivated. She's proved this year that she's capable of managing time effectively to deal with all the coursework tasks that come with child development, and has really, really impressed Mrs. Allen. She's really proud of everything that she's achieved this year and can't wait to see what she produces next year. So the Year 10 award goes to Carly Dean. Well done, Carly. Hello everybody, I'm going to announce the Health and Social Care Award winners for this year. So both nominations come from myself, and the Year 9 Award winner is somebody that just lights up the classroom every lesson. And even in lockdown, she's continued working hard, sending work in and making sure that she's up to date. She's enthusiastic about the subject, really wants to push herself to do well and produce excellent pieces of coursework, and that's been really pleasing to see. I'm really proud of the start that she's made to health and social care, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. So the Year 9 award goes to Bryony Bowen. Well done, Bryony. And the Year 10 award goes to a student who, since starting health and social care in Year 9, has worked her socks off. She takes a lot of pride in the work that she produces and wants to make sure it's at the highest possible standard. She takes on board feedback, goes away, improves work to try and strive for those top marks on each coursework task. She participates in lessons, answers questions, shares really good answers and learning with her fellow classmates, and she's been an absolute pleasure to teach. So the Year 10 award goes to Khalees Ricardo. Well done, Khalees.
Just a little clue as to which award this is. It is, of course, drama. The drama award goes to somebody who has impressed me so much with their hard work this year, and that person is Lois Francis. Lois, you've been an absolute star all year. You've worked so, so hard with a quiet determination. Your work in lockdown has been excellent, I absolutely loved your Beauty and the Beast presentation, and I loved your monologue. Your voice work is brilliant. Lois, you've never ever missed a drama club, right since you joined us in year seven. I'm so proud of you and how hard you've worked and all you have achieved. Well done, Lois. Congratulations! Wave to the camera, Lois! Oh, I do apologise. You've just caught me in my loungewear. Anyway, moving on to the RMS Awards. The Year 7 Award goes to a young man who has been fabulous this year. He works so hard in each and every lesson and is always inquisitive and keen to join in discussions. His work in lockdown has been excellent. He's also an RMS leader and works so hard at that. Never lets me down, is always there. And this person is Sam Foster. Well done, Sam, and well deserved. I'm really proud of you. Moving on to the Year 8 RMS Award. This award goes to a young lady who has been excellent this year. She works hard in each and every lesson anyway, and again has a thirst for knowledge and an inquisitive mind. During lockdown, her work has been phenomenal. She's gone above and beyond and researched the topics to produce work that is simply outstanding. And this person is Katie Ashley. Well done, Katie. You're an absolute star.
Stand up beside the fireplace. Take that look from off your face. Cause you ain't ever gonna burn my heart out.
Good evening, everyone. These are the awards for the music and dance. First of all, the award for Year 7 Music goes to someone who is really dedicated and really enthusiastic. She's also got a lot of talent and likes to take part in extracurricular activities. She always works hard and I'm sure she's going to continue to do well. And that is Tallulah Hunt. So well done, Tallulah. Keep up the good work. Secondly, this evening, the award for Year 9 Music. This goes to somebody who has really grown in confidence this year. She started out a little bit unsure of her own abilities and was often reluctant to take part in classroom question and answer activities in case she got the answers wrong. But she's really grown in confidence now. She's very dedicated. She's done an awful lot of independent learning over the last few months and is teaching herself to play the guitar and the ukulele, and her singing lessons are really coming on well. And that is Jessica Eardley. And finally, the award for Year 10 Dance. It's a really strong field in Year 10. We have a fantastic class of dancers this year. But the one who really stands out is someone who's so dedicated and so talented, and I know he's going to do well in the exams in the summer, and that is Aisha Yorukoglu. Thank you.
Decide it's on my destiny. What if we rewrite the story?
Welcome, everybody. Now, unlike the rest of the staff, I believe, who've allegedly been doing this in their pyjamas and all sorts of dressing up gear, I'm keeping the standards up, suit and boot, and we're keeping the standards high at Chesterton. Hello, boys.
Hello, Colin.
Okay, Key Stage 3 Contribution to School Life Award. This goes to a child who's flourished at CCSC. She's very polite, well-mannered, and very dedicated to learning. She contributes to all aspects of life, an excellent attendance record. She's had a lead role in the primary concert, attends netball clubs, keen dancer, attends history club and represented CCSC at many weekend events. And since September, this girl has broken the school record, ironically held by herself, of gaining the most event logs, massed over 800 event logs, which is unbelievable. Constantly smiling, bubbly, always willing to help everybody around her. The Key Stage 3 contribution to school life goes to Isabel Conyon.
Woo! Woo!
Mrs. Swindle's back here, still in a suit, not dressed up. Contribution to school life, Key Stage 3 boy. This young man is quiet but very astute and dedicated member of Year 8. He works hard in all his subjects, has a mature attitude, and often think he's in a higher year group because he is very mature to his studies. His name's mentioned everywhere, especially since lockdown, where he has worked very, very hard independently. He has an excellent attendance record, regularly attends clubs, takes all opportunities to be involved in school life, has earned over 700 event logs since September, and is the leading boy in the whole of the school. He's a form rep, helps out with many form activities, and has gained many, many event logs for his helpfulness around school. Everyone who speaks about him does so with pride, and I'm sure he will excel in his GCSE studies. He's fully engaged, like we've said before, in lockdown, and it's exciting to see what he goes on to do in his GCSEs. The Key Stage 3 award for boy goes to Ben Davenport.
Woo!
So tell me, do you want to go?
So I'm going to present the Key Stage 4 winners for the contribution to school life. We've got two winners. The first winner is a girl. She is exceptionally hardworking in all her subjects. She works quietly and independently, very well in school and during lockdown as well. She's proactive and plans her time really well so that she can achieve in every single subject she studies. Her attendance is excellent. She's very focused in all her lessons. And she always contributes ideas and answers. She attends a range of booster classes to support her learning, and she strives for perfection in everything she does. She takes part in a wide range of sporting activities and competes in a wide range of the school sports teams as well. This year she's taken part in her Duke of Edinburgh Award. The winner is Jasmine Heath.
Yay!
Okay, so the next winner for the Key Stage 4 contribution to school life is a boy. He's a very mature pupil. He's always very helpful to members of staff and pupils around the school. He's very kind, thoughtful, and a caring person. He's committed to his learning in all subjects, and he's always fully engaged in every single lesson. He attends boosters regularly. He's an MFL leader, and he's become a head prefect. He's been part of the peer mentoring programme and also supported Year 5 open days. Teachers always speak very highly of this pupil. He's independent, he's very motivated, and he always strives to achieve in every subject. The Key Stage 4 winner is Sam Ruane.
Whee!
We can share the night, it goes on and on.
Everyone, hope you're all well and staying safe. Certificate evening is always one of my favourite events of the year. It gives us an opportunity to celebrate the success in the school, with all of the subjects nominating prizes and awards for pupils. This year, due to lockdown, we have decided to celebrate two pupils who we think have really excelled during this period of time. In Year 7, there was a young man who has continuously made me smile. He has committed his lockdown experience to his education. He has contributed to live lessons. He has sent in work. He has sent in videos of his science experiments. And Miss Edwards will often send me work, and sitting at home, teaching from home, he always makes me smile. Our lockdown award goes to a boy in Year 7, and that is Ethan Cooper. Well done, Ethan. It has been a pleasure seeing your face, and you have really made me smile. We have one more award for a lockdown award, and that is a girl in Year 8. This girl has always been a good student. She's always worked hard. She's always given her best at CCSC. But what we have seen is that she has really, really succeeded. She has amounted to every piece of work. She has contributed to all subject areas. And I have seen her name everywhere. We are really proud of this girl because we know that she is going to come back in September and continue this success. The Year 8 award goes to Rhiannon Kearns. Well done, guys.
Hopeless after all, no one can rewrite the stars. How can you say you?
Okay, and that brings us to a close for our certificate evening this year. Thanks for joining us. Really hope you've enjoyed it. And I'd also like to give a special thanks to two people who've helped us out massively. Mrs. Hawkins, our driver, Miss Gittins, who was our camera lady. Without them, we couldn't have visited the 70-odd houses that we did to deliver the golden ticket. So thank you both.
A massive, massive congratulations to every single one of you. All your hard work has been amazing. So really, really proud of you. Hope you have a safe, safe summer holidays. And we hope to see you very, very soon.
Bye. Take care. Bye.
No one can rewrite the stars. How can you say you'll be mine?
That felt strange.
Woo! Woo!
Is contribution to school life the girl at oh.
Carry on! Come on, we're not doing it again. She can edit this. Come on.
Thanks to two people without whom this wouldn't have been possible. Mrs. Hawkins and Miss Gittins helped us out by driving us around.
Hard work has really, really paid off.
You were doing so well.
Actually, we could keep that as an outtake.
Oh, I do apologise. You've just caught me in my loungewear.
Love it. Well done.
Is it recorded?
Who I'm meant to be, this is me. Look out, cause here I come.